I can see you in the morning when you go to school. Don't forget your books, you know you gotta learn the golden rule. The teacher tells you stop your playing, get on with your work. And be like Johnny Too Good. Don't you know?
I've been trying so
hard. How many times have you failed?
Multiple, but you don't understand.
I understand that you're not trying hard
enough.
I need to see more.
How can you say something like that? I'm trying so hard.
I know what you're capable of. You just gotta keep going.
I failed so many times. When I was a child, I failed so many times. I don't think I can take it anymore.
You fail more times in life than you succeed. That's just how it works. And you hold it together, you do some real shit.
I'm Luisa, I am 21 years old, I am from the Netherlands, and this is my application to be a normal human being. Thank you so much. And here it comes.
April 2nd. I wish it was the 1st, because then this all could have been a fucking joke. For as long as I'm alive, I've had to annually reapply to be a human being, a filler to be correct. You know those people that you pass on the street but you don't make any eye contact with? Just pass. Those people that fill restaurants that are about to go broke. Who run on treadmills in a gym and wait in line to pay for their groceries in the supermarket. Plastic wrapped bags of lamb lettuce and canned pickles. People as thin as clouds, dressed in camouflage of Nike, Zara and H&M. People that dissolve into dimly lit homes at night and magically reappear as you wait for your 8 AM bus to arrive. But 7 seconds was all it took for me to get judged. A rub of the eyes, a photograph, a sneaky fart in the cinema, one sip of one drink, a taxi driver screaming fuck you at me for cutting off in traffic. 7 seconds in which you decide that I remain a filler or advance to the status of an acquaintance. A rule in which I can now nod my head at you in public, ask you about your plans for the summer, how your mom's doing. Sometimes we pretend we don't see each other because we both know our conversations are a bit dry. I want to get to know you, really. You seem great. We could be friends, but my head is somewhere else, and as I speak to you, it drifts off. Tells me I need to get rid of that ant invasion in my room because I left a rotting banana outside my windowsill for too long. I keep tuning in and out. My mind rises to the second, third, fourth floor, my body remaining on the first. You tell me about that one time your dog shat on your carpet, but my mind is already at an airport somewhere trying to illegally board a plane to whoever knows where. And that makes me a filler once more. Thank you.
It's not my problem.
So that rotting wisdom tooth is also not your problem. Nice, didn't you had there? It looked real tasty.
I tried. Come on.
I've seen you try a lot of things, you know. We've grown old together. You've had me for what, 17 years?
15. You were expensive.
Beauty doesn't come cheap, but your kind wouldn't understand.
You're a fucking toothbrush.
You're a failure.
You smell like cheese.
You smell like rejection.
Bitch.
Broke loose. To be fair, I paid £5 for this on the market. But what is the plan tonight, Luisa? I don't know. I was maybe gonna have a bath, but then I realized that the thing that prevents the water from leaving the bath is gone. I don't know how you lose that, because that's the one item in the house that should stay in the same place, because it has only one use. It's gone. Whatever.
At home right now, it's Friday night. I don't have any plans until the 3rd of June.
Because I have exams. I just realized that with these exams, right? Am I stressed? Yes, I am. Is it good stress? Yes, it is. It's stress that I'm supposed to have.
There is nothing that is stopping me from being phenomenal.
At least that's what I tell myself. Because I think you should believe in yourself in order to do well, you know? Who else is going to? Not the goddamn exam marker.
The thing is that you and me, I mean, we're both human beings. We both have a heart that beats and a mind that thinks, but it doesn't seem to matter when I sit next to you in a tube, see that you're reading a book that I love and I want to tell you about how good it will get, that it kind of sucks at the start but that you have to push through and wait till chapter 5. But I don't, I keep my mouth shut and head down and mind my own business, because I am a filler, or at least I used to be. I guess that now I'm nothing to anyone anymore. I'm the voice in a tube that tells you that you've arrived at Regent's Park, the mind your step at the airport, the keep in the clear of the garbage truck to your left, and the make a U-turn on the Google Maps of your phone. The voice that keeps the world spinning in orbit, that keeps gravity in nice levels so we don't all float up into the air dressed in cotton candy clouds and get high on plummeting levels of sweet O2. A lot can happen in 7 seconds.